When you think of the word tourist, you may imagine the combination of a Hawaiian shirt, shorts, socks, and sandals. Other stereotypes and images may pop into your head, good or bad. But according to the United Nations World Tourism Organization, a tourist is a person who travels and stays in a place outside of his or her usual environment for not more than one consecutive year for leisure, business, or other purposes. The definition of tourist may be wide and expansive, but not all tourists are the same. Scholars have developed a spectrum of tourist types. Tourists are divided into four groups based on demographic characteristics, lifestyle, personality, and more. The four groups or typologies are drifter, explorer, individual mass tourist, and organized mass tourists. Because this is a spectrum rather than four defined groups, some tourists may not fit into the tourist typologies, but may fall into different points on the spectrum. First typology is the drifter. The drifter does not consider themselves a tourist. They desire to discover the undiscovered and visit new and developing destinations. A drifter will immerse themselves in the culture as much as possible. They rely on local food and transportation. For some drifters, they are traveling for education and self-exploration. For others, it is about doing something different, something not usually done. Next, we have the explorer. The explorer travels for education, religious enlightenment, mental or physical well-being, or other specific types of experiences at the destination. An explorer will interact with not just individuals working the front desk, restaurant servers, or maintenance staff, but also the local population. Explorers arrange for their own travel and rely on both the tourism infrastructure and the local infrastructure. After the explorer, we have the individual mass tourist. The motivation for this tourist is relaxation, recreation, or diversion. An individual mass tourist will rely primarily on the tourism infrastructure for transportation and desire things that are familiar and comfortable. Individual mass tourists are interested in activities and experiences that are not available to them in their home environment. With caution and in a safe manner, they will seek the opportunity to explore the destination. On the far side of the spectrum, we have the organized mass tourist. The primary intention of travel for the organized mass tourist is diversion and escape from the boredom or repetition of daily life. The organized mass tourist emphasizes rest and relaxation. They will enjoy good food, entertainment, and accommodations familiar to them. The organized mass tourist is less interested in the unique experiences offered at their destination. They might stay in recognized brand name resorts and are highly dependent on the tourism infrastructure and services. The organized mass tourist would lean towards booking all-inclusive vacation packages involving less planning. Say we had four tourists headed to Thailand. John is our drifter. Rather than staying in the popular cities such as Bangkok, Chiang Mai, or Phuket, John would choose to stay in a lesser-known island or in the countryside in a town such as Sakhon Nakhon. While there, John would stay with locals or in local accommodations. John the drifter would shop at the morning market. John would rent or buy a moped and explore the city and nearby mountains. Next is Kate, the explorer. You may find Kate in Bangkok or Chiang Mai. Kate, the explorer, came to Thailand to experience the culture and experience Thai Buddhism. Kate tries the local food, visits the temples, and participates in some of the Buddhist ceremonies. Kate, the explorer, uses the train to get around and would stay in a place like a hostel. Then we have Mia, the individual mass tourist. While in Thailand, Mia would go to the tourist hotspot of Phuket. While in Phuket, Mia would venture out on a snorkeling trip booked through her hotel with pickup and drop-off. Mia, the individual mass tourist, eats at the restaurant across from the hotel with a mix of Thai food and American food. The hotel also has an attached spa. After a day out on the beach, Mia would come back and enjoy a nice massage at the spa. Finally, we have Dave, the organized mass tourist. Dave booked an all-inclusive resort in the beaches of Thailand. He is a member of the resort's global loyalty program and is cashing in on some of his earned points. On the resort property, Dave can enjoy a good game of golf, his favorite sport. The restaurant serves some Americanized Thai dishes and nothing too spicy for Dave to enjoy. If you wish to work in the tourism sector, understanding the different typologies of tourists is important. Not only do you better understand your guests, but you can anticipate the needs and wants of your guests.